that you are the Father. Lead your people to finish this service in a wonderful and marvelous way. And we will give you all the glory. We thank you for such a moment. As the word of God is coming, Lord, inspire me to preach your word. And let your people hear your word and walk in your word. May your word bless the soul and help us, Lord, to walk in your word and be blessed in the spirit, in the physical, and in all ways. We give you all the glory. We bless you, mighty Father. Let me speak like you want me to speak. And let all what you let me speak be a blessing to your church. We bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
This afternoon I want to preach on the subject, Godliness with Contentment is Great Gain. And we are reading from 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 6 to 8. Godliness with contentment is great gain. Hallelujah. So reading from 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 6 to 8.
Yeah, Timothy number 18.
Let's hear the word of God. We're reading from the New International Version. But godliness with contentment is great gain. For we brought nothing into the world, and we can take nothing out of it. But if we have food and clothing, we will be content with that. Amen. For we brought nothing into the world, and we will take nothing out of it. It will be very strange to see somebody coming from the mother's womb and wearing jacket and shoes and so many
things.
I've been necklaces all around. Nobody will come like that.
You'll
come naked. When you are going, you can't take anything away. But even the clothes that will be putting on you, it will rot in the dust. Before the Lord comes, you will be in that grave naked. So it's true, you come with nothing and you go with nothing. So because we will go with nothing, what are we seeking for in this world? What are all the fightings and the insults and so many things? We will all go. So the Apostle Paul was saying that we brought nothing and we take nothing out of it. But what is very important and will give you great gain is godliness with contentment. So I was searching for the word contentment in the dictionary. What is contentment at all? If it is great gain, and we will gain much from it, then what is it at all? One dictionary defines contentment as the state of being mentally and emotionally satisfied with all things. So we get another word, satisfaction. Therefore we can say, godliness with satisfaction on what God is doing in our lives And in the church,
any
is great achievement. Hallelujah. Fellow Christians, contentment is good in all aspects of Christian life. So in this farewell service, I want to advise all Christians here and those who will be watching the video to be content with all what God is doing in our lives and for the entire church. Okay, I want to speak to three groups of people. The first group is all the members of the church. The second is all the officers of the church. And the third is all ministers gathered here and those watching. Okay, so let's begin with the members. All church members must be content, satisfied when a minister is being transferred to work among them. And they must also be content when he is transferred out of them. Can I hear amen here? You see, sometimes members grow in love for their minister and his family. To the extent that they never expect the leadership of the church to transfer him and the family. Some of these members are sometimes grieved about the transfer. Some become angry even with the leadership of the church. I heard that somebody, a minister, was transferred to a station and someone heard it and he said, "Can I speak to the chairman of the church of
Pentecost?"
So tell your neighbor beside you, be content of all what God is doing. In my ministry, I was transferred once from a bigger district to a smaller one. And in fact, it was very small. And a very challenging place. Some people were even calling me from the United States and saying, "Hey, we've heard that the place that they transferred you to, the Americans are there." And when the transfer announcement came, some of the members cried. That is not bad. It is a sign of good relationship with the minister. I'm not giving you license to cry this afternoon. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But some of them went further to say, "It is not fair for a senior pastor to be transferred to that place."
Now, if you cross the cross, and yet cross, so who pay me for it? You don't have to be a sister.
Some even wanted to call the national head.
Now, if you cross the cross, and yet cross, so who pay me for it?
What were they going to tell the national head?
I said, "Man, pan and come back again.
If I don't go."
Send me man,
who should go?
One can go. I said, "This I don't
know." You see?
Yeah. Well,
I don't go.
Send man,
who should go?
One pan on the young girl.
Do we call some ministers and put them in villages and smaller places
and then call some people and put them on bigger districts in cities because they are city guys.
No question, sir. We say, yes, grass, what could you be somebody here? A grass is only on my sofa. Now, yes, we have used somebody here. Crocus, you and so many on my sofa.
But in all this, you see, I was content, satisfied going to that place.
Now, no question, we say, not me, who and Jimmy will be here near Jimmy.
And I thank the former chairman M.K. Yeboah because he gave me an advice as a father which has helped me a lot.
Now, me tell your papa when you bear before a papa prophet Yeboah. Oh, choose me for me. Now, I'm me.
Prophet said, in this ministry, wherever they sent you, go with satisfaction.
But if you want to say, that's what I said, what's that? If you want to be here, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to
never complain.
Me yano
go.
Uliani sako.
And it is true.
Na ayeko question for you.
Sometimes you hear some ministers saying that he doesn't like me. That is why he transferred me to that place.
I don't have the answer. Say something. He said, "One person say more. One more person say more. I'm telling you, I just have
the answer." But if your head doesn't like you and he transfers you to that place, God will be with you there.
No question. He says, "Say what's up."
So a pastor told me,
"See, question.
My head threw me.
My soul, or threw me.
When I was landing, God caught me."
Yes.
Oh, you see, so if you are content,
it is a
ubuchua, and you listen to God,
now we see your
wherever you go,
he
will be with you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you know what?
Now we believe.
I counted many miracles in that station than all the stations I had ever been. So remember. He always contend when your minister is being transferred to another station. Because he will be a blessing there to many believers and even unbelievers. You never knew Apostle Kwe was coming here to do mighty things here. And some of the German people were crying that day.
Now, be not here if you are not here, if you want to
you. See, somebody will hold you and you feel that the person will be shaking inside him or her.
So, the deal who saw me, I want to know who said the Buddha and Gasan and Wusu.
They cried. And when he came here,
now, Obahano,
look at how you are testifying. You are happy today. And after today, he will go to Germany. The people will welcome him. And
they
will rejoice there. You will be crying. And another time they will cry. And some people will rejoice. So if you make this thing your habit that all ministers who are going to die, you
will die. If it's only one you know, so for me, I'll be behind. You need to be sure. And you'll be sure when you say yes, sir.
It's normal.
It's answer. And I'm here. That's how I saw in the moon.
So even if you will cry,
it is always one.
Because breaking relationship or departing is difficult.
It's answer. In terms of this year,
after weeping for a short time,
we should have cried
and departed.
Now, in what is it?
Regain your contentment.
Now, for what's in your heart?
Hallelujah. So you see, when your minister is being transferred to another station, he becomes a blessing to that place. What he needs from you is to pray for him. That the
work
there will be successful. You know something? You see, sometimes you look at farewells like this are being transferred to so many places. And you see people crying.
Now, go for soon.
I even went to a station and somebody was doing something and I disciplined her, suspended her.
That's
our way. But when we were doing transfer, she hugged me and cried and said, "Not if not because of you, I wouldn't have known the Lord." Glory be to God. So we go to places and the Lord uses us to bless them. And sometimes you look at people who were crying and wailing, and you think, well, if I go, these people will call me every day.
And see, who's up on the side? I don't say. See, I'm going to go to the side. They call me from the area.
You move from that nation or that district or that area.
We're not far from that. I'm going to go to the area.
And you've been waiting and waiting. Weep and not forget him. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, we must be also content for the minister who will be coming. Receive the minister, the new minister who is coming to replace the outgoing. I'm saying this because sometimes some people find it difficult to receive the one who is coming. Normally people think the pastor who is here going is the better than the one coming. And if you don't take care and you hear about him that he even once rebuked somebody, hey, that man, they say he rebuked people.
Now,
So you see, because the Lord is the head of the church, the one who goes has finished his work, the one who is coming will come and continue. And I thank the Lord for all the testimonies you have given for the 3 days that I've been here. It means Apostle Ebenkwe has built a good foundation. He has put in some things down. And when the incoming minister arrives, he can build upon it.
Amen.
And that means the one coming will also do greater things. Because the Lord will use him as instrument. You see, we are instruments of God. No axe can say, "I am good in pulling down trees," unless a muscle man holds it and pulls down the tree.
I
have to be lying down there. Sharpened. Can do anything. So we have all been sharpened by the Holy Spirit. But as ministers, if the Lord is not leading us, we can't do anything. So it's my prayer that the outgoing minister will be used by the Holy Spirit to move the nation Germany. And the incoming minister will also be used to lead the nation Belgium. So here we will see the church Growing up and Germany, the church will also be rising. Okay, and to the members, what I want to say lastly is that respect your ministers. When a man of God is sent to you, work with him with good heart and with reverence. Don't look at the other ministers who are cheating people and doing so many fake things and say, all ministers these days are the same. We are not the same. And don't imitate people who don't respect men of God. Some people, they can say anything to whoever you are. They can just stand before you and say, what do you think? Who do you think you are? If God anoints somebody, he stands before the Lord. He works for the Lord. And he stands in the presence of the Lord to do all what the Lord wants him to do. So if you disrespect him or do anything that is evil, God will not look at you to go free.
You
see, Moses was a leader of the Jews.
Now Moses, yeah, Israel for the power of Germany.
And you see, he married a Cushite wife. And Aaron and Miriam said, what do Moses think he is?
Now Miriam, Moses, I never pass your first wife.
God can speak to all of us. It was a short statement. And God said, you three of you, come here. Moses, Aaron, Miriam, come.
Moses, Aaron, Miriam,
came in front of the Lord.
Then
you two, step forward. So you, why are you saying so many things against my prophet?
Oh.
When I call prophets, you see, I speak to them in dreams and revelations. But to this man, I speak to him face to face. And you didn't fear. When they were going, leprosy fell on Miriam.
Hey.
Yes, away.
Okay.
So those of you who speak just like that, be careful.
Can you?
I'm not saying leprosy is coming on. I'm saying be very careful. Watch your words.
Nothing. Come on,
amen.
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 Amen. Let's move on to the church officers. Church officers are also advised to be content that the leadership of the church are taking their co-worker and bringing them another
one.
Let me stand here and tell you emphatically that the executive council have not done any mistake.
International and about but do for
that is their work. And before they do anything, they pray. And the Holy Spirit gives them directions. When they come out with transfers,
so back
we as the ministers accept the transfer with satisfaction. God will always be with us. So, officer, be content and work happily with your minister. Whoever comes to you. Again, be content with your salvation and the position the Lord has placed you. You see, if you are satisfied, if you are content, you will not fight. So be content, be satisfied for the transfer that has come. And be also content that you are going to work with somebody. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Don't fight for positions. If you fight for positions, you will bring confusion in the church. And fighting in the church retards the progress of the church. And so you must be content with even the salvation that you have received. After all, if you are not a member and you are content with your salvation, you will still go to heaven. See, sometimes you look at some people and it seems that officers, when we are going to heaven, officers will be at the front and workers will be at the second and the members at last and Sunday school at the bottom.
Say you go help me. Officers, you be the kind. Now I show you in check. Come. Now members know if you check. Now Sunday school for the towards the children.
You'll be surprised one day when Jesus comes and you see the Sunday school children at the front.
They say, "I better walk with you because you pass." The Jesus appear. But we say Sunday school now here na toko adikino. I know na very kind.
And some fighting and struggling officers being at the bottom.
Now, the officers be around there, we shall do my lesson. Close. Now, I'll come to whom I was so long. Now, I'll catch you, bruh.
Some officers are never satisfied with the leadership of the church.
Now, officers, we move over. Why? So, both for granted, and even back.
When their personal desires are not achieved, what they are expecting, if it doesn't come to pass, they become angry. They always walk in meetings with anger spirit. My dear brother, my dear officer, let the will of God precede your desires and the Lord will bless your life. When a minister comes into your midst to work, you must be content, you must be satisfied, you have to work with him with whole heart. And the Lord will bless your life. You see, Apostle Paul was a missionary. And he preached in many cities. In his ministry, some people served him and, I mean, worked hard. So when you read Romans chapter 16, he mentioned many names there. I remember he mentioned even Mary and said that woman worried herself so much. But at a certain point, he mentioned someone's name. And he said, Alexander the coppersmith.
Now, Alexander, copy your phone.
Let's read from 2 Timothy chapter 4. I want you to get the very word there. Yeah, 2 Timothy chapter 4.
Timothy, woman, adoption, you know, 89.
Verse 9 to
16.
Listen to what the Bible says. Do your best to come to me quickly. For Demas, because he loved this world, has deserted me and has gone to Thessalonica. Christians have gone to Galatia and Titus to Dalmatia. But listen to what he said to another person.
Now, until your catcher will be so.
Only Luke is with me.
Now, Luke, now, I never know what.
Get Mark and bring him with you.
Now, for Marco, I can't remember the
back. Because he is helpful to me in my ministry.
He said, Sam, Marky,
some of us, when we go to any place, we mention some people's names.
Hey,
you are talking about this elder.
Hey,
he's good.
Hey,
I remember once of the apostles called me from a certain
nation.
He said, one of your guys are here. We are planning to open a district there. We want to ask you if that elder is good. That elder was not just good, good. So I said, oh, apostle, that guy. I wanted to make him presiding elder and he ran. So catch him there and before the year got to an end, he was a presiding elder. He was very helpful in my ministry. An apostle could go to Germany and say, this brother, that sister was very helpful in my ministry. Or will he go and say he was a thorn in my flesh? So we have helpful people and torn people. They are like nails. When you are being uplifted by the Spirit, they will prick you and you.
Yes.
12. Send Titus to Ephesus.
Ephesus.
When you come, bring the cloak that I left with Carpus at Troas. And my scrolls, especially the parchments. Alexander the metal worker. Did me a great deal of the Lord will repay him for what he has done. Apostle Paul, this is strong. It's strong. But Alexander also did something strong to him. And listen to how he was advising Timothy. You should be on your guard against him. Because he strongly opposed our message. I pray to God this afternoon. That no member will oppose the word of God. Because you can oppose everybody. But if you oppose the word of God, Jesus said to Paul,
Jesus got your power.
Can you kick your leg to the
frame?
You can never. So, officer.
Anything, officer.
When you go to meetings, and you share your mind, maybe what you are sharing is good and powerful. But you were serving people. 5 people said, oh, for this one, let's make it next year.
Even though
you got somebody who was backing you, the yes man, yes, yes. When the 5 of the people says no, that's
accepted.
Don't go out and say, as for me, I was not in agreement with them, and these people, you see, whatever you say, they will not listen to you. I don't know why me, I'm still in this church, and so on and so on. So no, no,
no.
Be content with all what God is doing in your life. After all, what are you searching for? If you are a member, and you are ordained to be a deacon. And God helps you and you become an elder. All of them are good. Member is good. Deacon is good. Elder is good. Where do you want to be? You want to be an elder? When you become an elder, what do you want to be?
Overseer.
Then you start waiting for pastor.
And I say, who are thinking when you are pastor? See, I'm about to call.
And when you become pastor,
I say, you're about to call.
You want to be an apostle.
Okay, so you're a small fool.
When you become apostle,
so you're a small fool.
You want to be.
Sometimes
we desire so many things.
Now, I told them, yeah, they need that so many people.
Even you are content with where you are. Friday, I heard something I was laughing. You see, when I was being transferred from Italy to Austria. Somebody said, Apostle, we thank God for your life. We are praying that you will be the next chairman. Now, so go and tell chairman.
Chairman,
when I came here, I had another brother. Was also saying,
Apostle,
you will be the next chairman. You see, you want us to fight.
Oh, my God.
And somebody was also saying to
France. A different answer. I'll be the
next chairman.
I want to be the next chairman. Come say that you're Ugum, sir.
I'm praying to God.
Now, we're going to have empire.
That after this chairman.
Now, if it's that chairman, you see.
There will be 3 chairmen. Let us be content. Content and satisfied to be an apostle of the church of
Pentecost.
And I don't want anything else. In fact, what I need is to be a minister of God and preach the gospel. I'm not satisfied that I'm an apostle. I'm satisfied about the place where the Lord has put in me. To minister his word. And to be part of his ministry. So if you are a member, be content. If you are a minister, be content. And if you do that, the Lord will bless your life.
Now
when you want to minister,
yeah, but I thought also.
Ministers must also be content wherever the Lord can send them to work.
Na asofo no ekoda be dia ya mini mo kunna mo sumu mama mani nyeho.
So you see, some ministers are not satisfied when they hear the white paper.
Na ekesha asofo ni kuwa wamani itani ni wapase white paper ni itia.
They are transferred to a smaller district.
Na you feel ha konya manchea ekesha.
If we follow the owner of the church and be content wherever he sends us, we will be successful everywhere. Sometimes we are moved from bigger mission houses to smaller ones. I bought a new car, the place where I was transferred. And when I went to my new station, there wasn't a new car there. It was old, but I enjoyed it.
Now
people came to me and they said, we want to buy you a new car. And I said, not now. Because I have a vision. And there is something I want to do. And after I have done it,
you
can do whatever you want.
You're
looking at the
authority.
And I said, this is what I want. Some people will grab everything. And you say, Bukwan, I say. Then we must be content with whatever we have. So you see, sometimes we move from mission houses, bigger ones to smaller ones, from bigger cars to smaller ones.
So there be a few mission houses like a same, and then one, and then baby, and then he.
You can even move from district and nations that the people are generous.
And
you go to some places.
Now,
the people are so stingy.
Now,
even Christmas time,
and they do pepper and
what you will get is bread, chocolate.
Yeah,
says be content in the name of Jesus. Because the Lord will never leave us nor forsake us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We should be content.
And to say
and focus on the growth of the church. Without
murmuring.
And the good Lord will never leave us. The Apostle Paul was a man who suffered and went without food, comfort, and so many. Yet he knew the secret of contentment. So he said in Philippians chapter 4, verse 12, and I quote. I know what it is it to be in need. And I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content. So tell your neighbor, learn the secret of being content. I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation. Whether well fed or hungry. Whether living in plenty or in want. Apostle.
Osumafo.
Mama Rosalie.
Okay, Mama Rosalie.
Be content for all that the Lord is doing in your family. I'm satisfied about what the Lord is doing in my family. And in my children. Sometimes I praise the Lord for my children. We don't have much. But we pray to the Lord to let our children be successful. You come to the mission house and they will serve you. We taught them how to respect the everyone. And they did it.
Now,
when the apostles passes by,
now, pray
over them.
Oh, tell what did Pablo go
and pray out? Many successful things upon them. And they are growing in the law. We went to the graduation of one of my daughters. And in the University of Benin's. It's not a small thing.
And
we were sitting down there and we look at the whites. I don't even know the number. It was more than 500. You mentioned her name and she was coming and the whites were clapping for the black woman. And I was proud about that. And on the graduation day, the whites were going inside and coming out. They soon needed 101 man, 103. Some goes in and come out and they say we've got 80. Some go in and say we've got 85 and they clap for them. The white lady went inside and there were so many questions and they finished everything. Oh, the black lady, that's my daughter. She came out and they proclaimed 103 over 103.
Mucho, I'm not sure by I'm coming the results are all Piabano. 103 or handing the chip on me and Samuel. When getting in us, you.
So who says black man is nothing in the world?
If you want to be pure,
we can do all things through Christ who strengthens
us. We believe to be a dinner when Yeshua or Sunday
in the
morning.
Be content in the church of the Lord. And the Lord will bless you and your generation. So I pray to God
and give me your empire
that. While you are going to Germany, the Lord will be with you. And in fact, you will increase.
An increase.
People will hear about you. And they will say, the Lord is with Apostle
Quay.
Go with your family in contentment. Wherever you go and meet there, be content. And the Lord will be on your side. And you will flourish. In conclusion, the Bible does not encourage us to be content with sin or
any.
Therefore, if you are sinning against God, the church and anyone, stop that.
Amen.
The Bible encourages to be content or satisfied with the things of God. Therefore, if we worship the Lord in a state of contentment, there will be great gain in the church.
Oh,
na ahim nyamma betum po akwanim.
It is my prayer today.
Me bonya me paye na sir.
That God will bring great increase into your life.
Na oyame adi amaye emu amaye ebe ba wa brabo mu.
Spiritually. Numerically and financially, because you are going to look unto him with satisfaction. You will open up your spirit and let the Holy Spirit lead you in the church and become mature in the church. You see, you'll be content with all things.
And
when you are content in the Lord, you will get great gain in your life. So godliness with contentment is great gain. God bless you.
Amen.
The Lord. I think